years for you to have a triple-double. You've done it before, obviously, but just in a game like this where, you know, you guys win a tight one and every possession was mattering at the end, is how you're feeling about the way the guys play overall?
Guys play great. I mean, we stuck together, you know. In time like this, got a lot of guys out. You know, we waiting on a lot of guys to come back. So different guys stepped up, and it's a great team win for us. That's how we've been played for the last year and a half.
You had a career high, 14 boards. Did you even know what your career high was?
No clue. No clue. Yeah.
I mean, but today, was that an emphasis for you? As the game was going on, like maybe I need to help out on glass?
No, I don't pay attention to it. You know what I mean? I'm sure as many nights I could have got a triple-double. I don't know how many times I had 9 rebounds or whatnot, but you just play. Like, it is what it is. I done played with a lot of big men. A lot of big men want that rebound. So if they got to touch the basketball first or whatever, then so be it.
You guys are 25-0 this year, one leading after 3 quarters.
Good luck to his next game.
Huh?
Good luck to his next game.
Well, just wondered why that closing group seems so kind of dialed in. It seems like a lot of times teams will get close, but you guys are able to kind of come on.
I think we've built a lot of trust. We've been in a lot of different situations last year. We talk about it all the time when you watch games and you watch close games all season long on league pass and stuff. Some teams' biggest issue is they don't know what they want to run or who they want to go to down the stretch. I think we have a good sense of that. You know, we know what our go-to plays are, and we know where we're trying to get to. But Cam Johnson isn't afraid to take a big shot. Jay Crowder isn't. Mikael Bridges, everybody. So I think for us, we play the same way all game long, no matter what.
It was nice to have all them extra coaches out there tonight.
Now they need to put a uniform on, you know, but it's great to see, man. You know, like, we was on the road playing without those guys. So it's nice to actually play with them guys here and to see, you know, all the talking to Bismack, to Sticks. Sticks is the guy that I'm probably most proud of because I'm in his ear all game long. And to see it all come together. And he gets a chance to, a lot of times I'm talking to Sticks on the bench during the season and he's not necessarily playing. Now I'm saying it to him and he's getting a chance to play and see how it works out. So it's dope.
Something Monty talked about is just being proud of him, particularly for just how he's improving kind of on the fly here game by game. Are you seeing that process?
Absolutely. I'm in Sticks here all game long when we're over there on the bench. And I'm just sort of saying, look at this. If you said it like this, said it like this. And then he gets a chance to put it into action, and he can really play, man. And I'm glad that he's getting a chance to see all the little details that go in to being great.
Chris, seeing how Demo's out for some time and recently with coaches and some players, and seeing how you guys now have 30 wins, I just want to ask you, how proud are you of seeing what they've been able to do in the circumstances of the season?
I didn't know we had 30 wins, so you just said that. I think for us, man, we just be building. We just keep building. We have such high expectations for us, regardless who's in the lineup. And it's a fun team to be on when going into every game, you expect to win, right? You know, if you do what you're supposed to do, you should win. And it's a fun way to play.
All right. Appreciate it.
All right. Have a good one.